We've been surrounded. Welcome back to Daniel's family homestead. Today, Jeremy went and bought a couple loads of hay. We've run out. We didn't have enough hay left to get us through to spring. Luckily, Jeremy's dad knew somebody that had a whole bunch of hay left and was needing to sell it. But he was all the way over in Kentucky, almost in Harlan, Kentucky. So that was a long trip for Jeremy to drive, but it was a good deal on the hay, and we needed some, so he was willing to make the trip. This is the first load of hay that Jeremy went and got today. After he unloads this trailer full, he's got to go back and get another. This ain't very high quality hay, but this is the best we could do for a reasonable price around this time of year. And something about this year, it's real hard to find hay. I don't know what went on, but it's just hard to find it, and when you do find it, it's real expensive. Last roll on the trailer.
Get the hay bale. You want to back up and get over. Do it straight. those steers so they all are safe. I'm teaching her how to drive the tractor and stack hay. That way, if anything ever happens to me, if I get sick and can't do it, she can. Back up a little.
Move gas. Now go up a little bit. Nope, other one. There you go. Kill it a little. Oh. Back the other way. That'd be good.
Okay.
Go the other way a little bit.
Other way.
Try it. Good thing, man. Turn your wheels. Hop. Forward. Raise it up. There she goes. That's good. Now go backwards. Oh yeah, she's a good lady.
Well, I just got done driving the tractor for the very first time. And obviously got done unloading my first two hay rolls for the very first time. It was an experience. Jeremy's a lot better at it than I am. And a lot quicker. I just think that's something that, you know, I'll have to work on a lot. Like, I'll have to drive it a lot and use all the little levers and stuff and get used to driving it. But I feel a little more confident now that he's let me run the tractor for a few minutes. I know it's something that will be good for me to know how to do, because you never know what's going to happen in the future, and it's always best to be prepared and know how to do things. All right, we're going to back the truck up here and turn it around, and Jeremy's gonna load the last bale of hay on the back of the truck, and we're gonna take it up on the hill and roll it out for the cows. Even going to complain about that sunshine. I'm just glad it's out. We made it up here to roll the hay off, and Brownie came and met me at the gate. He said he's hungry and ready for some hay. And there's old Chloe girl over there. Chloe just couldn't help herself. Here's some of the white faces. That one's Brownie. There's another white face and her baby. Cows are too friendly. We've been surrounded. Okay. I think I'm down here where I can see good now, so maybe y'all can see the hay roll downhill real good. If he can get the cows out of the way. Here comes Chloe around behind you. Come on, cows. Come on. Look at all that hay dust. Well, we got all the family up here eating. Good family dinner.